Welcome back to the Ghostski. I am Gray, and today we're gonna get started on Sabrina's gym. So yeah, this should be a pretty good test for Ellie. They're mostly she's what, psychic? Isn't that right? I can't remember, but I'm kind of like lost here for a second. And this is very, very similar to the last gym she had, right? I think it was, yeah. We're just gonna go in here, beat up the old ladies, and then we'll get ready for Sabrina. Depending on how long it takes me, I think I'll just stop the episode right before Sabrina and do our normal, or at least what I like to do. You know, save the gym leader for an episode on their own. Holy fucking shit, she's got a Bronzor. I didn't expect that. Can you X-Scissor this? Cause will that work on you? Cause I know you're steel. Oh, you bitch. You bitch. Skill swap. Alright. Well, that's okay, because we're just gonna pursue you and take you out here, my friend. Although you just totally took away our technician, but now we got her back, bitch! Scoop Singleton rides again! Get out of here! Oh my gosh, he's got a hypno. Holy shit, I thought she only had one! I'm scared. Yeah, not really. Hypno should be easy-peasy stuff for us. Yeah. It's just the way it is. I'm not really too afraid of Sabrina. I did take a look at her Pokemon to see what level they are. They are like 51s and 53s. She's only got three of them, though, so I think Ellie should be fine. As long as they're not throwing rocks and lightning bolts and shit at us. With that being said, that fight probably will go pretty quick. I'm really just choosing random little pods here to step on. So, it's pretty much what I've got for this gym. Like I said, it shouldn't be too hard. I'm not really that worried about it. Hopefully, like I said, this will be a good test for Ellie. I think it should be a good proving ground for her, and I think you know, this will kind of demonstrate why I brought a fucking Scyther along to exorcise the shit out of everything. But like I said, we'll see. Yeah, super effective. Yeah, let's say these Mr. Mimes and stuff should not be standing up to us, not be standing up to Ellie with the physical power that she's got. You know, execute. You know, we're just gonna keep on. You know, keep on battling here and use another X-Scissor. We might run out of those, but we got the Night Slash and the Pursuit with Technician, don't forget. And we've still got the Wing Attack if all else fails. Not that Wing Attack, you know, it's really gonna do much to them, but once again, if we get in the bind, we always get the stab, execute, we always get the stab, Wing Attack. So, I'm not too worried about that. On a side note, I'm recording this on a Sunday, and on the next Tuesday, which is 2 days from now, the Borderlands pre-sequel is coming out. So, over the next few days after I get that, don't expect any episodes. I know that may be a little disappointing, and in fact, this episode might end up being posted after the game comes out, for which I apologize. However, you know, I love Borderlands, and my girlfriend has her days off during when it comes out, which her weekend, she gets a 3-day weekend. Yeah, her weekend is Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, so that's what our plans are, is playing Borderlands. So yeah. So like I said, there probably won't be any episodes up around then, because I'm pretty stoked to play that game. Not too sure, honestly, about the damn clap traps, but it'll be fun nonetheless. I'm looking forward to it. And this is gonna be a good fall for games. I mean, I think I've said this before, but we do have that game coming out. We've got several others. You know, we got Pokemon coming out, obviously, you know, in November. The WoW expansion. Shut up, Georgia. God damn it. Quit playing with your goddamn toy. Sorry, the dog wants to go over there and squeak her fucking toy. Anyhow, yeah, now I'm all out of fucking sorts. I don't even know where I was going with any of this shit. But anyway, like I was saying, you know, this, I'm gonna try Night Slash. See how good Night Slash does against this poor Kadabra. But this fall is a good fall for games. Like I said, we got, you know, Borderlands coming out, and then we have the World of Warcraft expansion coming out, which I'm not super excited about personally. I mean, I'm interested to see a couple things, but my girlfriend wants to go play it, so I was like, yeah, whatever, we'll go do that. I'm pretty flexible with shit like that. So I'll be playing that a little bit this fall. And then, of course, like I said, Pokemon. Oh, I'm all excited for that. And, of course, Borderlands, as I've said, for like the 10th time now in this episode. I'm super excited about that. Super, super, super excited about that. What I'm even more excited about is how fucking Ellie is just tearing through all these things. Just bam! Knocking these fuckers down one by one. I love Scyther. Seriously, I do. You know, I used to always like Scyther until I used one. I think it was in my... When I played through Gen 5 or something, I used a Scyther all the way through, and I had so much fun with that thing. So much fun. And it was just a beast. A beast. Especially with Technician. Oh, it's so fun. So fun. I have no idea which one of these... I think we fought... Have we fought all the people so far? I want to say we did. I think if I'm missing any of them, it's that one bitch right up there in the left-hand corner. Where do you take me? I don't even fucking pay attention to where these things take me. I have like a general recollection of where it takes me. Did I fight you already, lady? Nope. All right. I'm okay with that. No, that's fine. So this is the last square we haven't been to. But Ellie, you know, we'll take, maybe make quick work of this lady. It's just okay. We're doing all right here. Doing all right on time too. Slowpoke. Ah, he's got a slowpoke. Slowpoke. Have you seen the mega for that thing? That's pretty much all I got for it. It's like, oh look, it's being eaten by a clam. Good for you, slowpoke king or king poke, whatever you are. Now, God only knows. But I did see the new Rayquaza thing. That thing was kind of odd looking. That's pretty much all I've got for that. I mean, like I said, like, you know, I remember when Gen 6 was coming out, I was all over that shit. He's got Slowbro. Sorry, I had fucking, like, got distracted. I'm like, what the fuck is she doing now? I'm gonna try X's. Shouldn't be really any difference, but yeah, I think I'll survive this. But when Gen 6 came out, I was really excited. I mean, I was kind of actually checking for news. I just wanted to see the new Pokemon. That's what I get excited about. I get excited about new Pokemon. Quite truthfully, like, the last two gens, for me, have been a little disappointing. However, at the same time, like, through playing Gens 5 and 6, I've been able to kind of rediscover some oldies but goodies, you know what I mean? I mean, and I enjoyed that, you know, kind of, like, rediscovering... You know, some old Pokemon, like Scyther. Like I said, when I played through Black 2, I think it was, with the Scyther. Oh, that was so much fun. So much fun. Love that Scyther. I got Brick Break, it was a fucking monster. You know, and it was just, it just tore shit up. And, you know, and that's... And if that's gonna be, like, the worst thing that happens when a generation has rather disappointing Pokemon, you know, I mean, I guess it's alright, you know? But anyhow, you know, because good came of it, you know what I mean? But anyhow, that about does it for this episode. If you made it this far on YouTube, you know what to do. Thanks a lot for watching. And remember, the Ghost Key is the only place where pants are optional.